greetings to the students. Next theory topic. Last time we have discussed about the work done by constant force. Now the next topic is kinetic energy. Actually in physics there are so many kinds of energy: kinetic energy, potential energy, gravitational potential energy, electrical energy, magnetic energy, nuclear energy. So here the kinetic energy. What is kinetic energy? You know very well, the expression of kinetic energy is 1 half mv square. This equation automatically says that it is related with motion of the particle. Until the particle is not in motion, it do not possessing any energy, any kinetic energy. But if it is in motion with certain speed, then and only then it possesses a certain energy, and that energy related with its motion is known as kinetic energy. So what is kinetic energy? The capacity of doing work by the body due to virtue of its motion is known as its kinetic energy. मतलब अगर कोई पार्टिकल मोशन में है एंड ड्यूरिंग मोशन इसके पास कुछ वर्क करने की कैपेसिटी है तो वर्क करने की कैपेसिटी इज नोन एज काइनेटिक एनर्जी. सो कैपेसिटी ऑफ डूइंग वर्क और एबिलिटी ऑफ डूइंग वर्क बाय द बॉडी ड्यू टू वर्च्यू ऑफ इट्स मोशन इज नोन एज इट्स काइनेटिक एनर्जी. इफ वेलोसिटी ऑफ अ बॉडी ऑफ मास m इज v, देन इट्स काइनेटिक एनर्जी इज गिवन बाय 1 हाफ एम वी स्क्वायर. टू दिस इक्वेशन यू मल्टीप्लाई बाय मास, डिवाइड बाय मास, तो क्या मिलेगा? एम स्क्वायर वी स्क्वायर अपॉन ट्वाइस एम. बट एज यू नो एम वी इज इक्वल टू वॉट? प्रोडक्ट ऑफ मास एंड वेलोसिटी इज लीनियर मोमेंट. So that's why the numerator is replaced by t square and you will get in denominator twice m. So another equation of kinetic energy is p square by twice m. And from this expression you can also define. क्या लिखेंगे इसके ऊपर से? वर्ड्स में the half of the product 1 by 2 है, मतलब half of the product. किस किस का product? Product of mass and squared velocity of a body. The half of the product of mass and squared velocity of a body is also be known as kinetic energy. So yeah, the kinetic energy ka topic finish. Then as we have seen earlier, the work done by constant force. So now here we have to discuss a little about it. SI unit of work, as you know, joule. Dimensional equation is F into D per se milega aapko m1 L square t raised to minus 2. Other alternative units are what? In CGS system, the unit of work is erg, and 1 joule equal to 10 raised to 7 erg. So 1 erg equal to 10 raised to minus 7 joule. In nuclear physics, you will use the unit of energy as electron volt. 1 electron volt equal to, you can write 1 E multiplied by 1 V. 1 E matlab charge of electron 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. And 1 volt equal to 1 joule per coulomb. So coulomb, coulomb cancel. Answer is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 joule. So 1 electron volt is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 joule. Next unit is unit of energy is calorie. Actually it is a unit of heat energy. Calorie is there. And 1 calorie equal to how much joule? So 1 calorie is equal to 4.186 joule. Then another one more unit of energy is kilowatt hour, that is kWh, or you can write this is the unit of work is there, or unit of kinetic energy is there. From the work energy theorem you will say that the unit of work be the same as that of unit of energy. So either you say kilowatt hour is the unit of work or is the unit of energy. And 1 kilowatt hour, that is 1 kWh, is equal to 1 kilowatt multiplied by 1 hour. 1 kilo, kilo that is 1000 watt. And 1 hour equal to 3600 second. Then what equal to kya? Joule per second. So 1000, that means 10 raised to 3 joule per second into 3600 second. So this is 36 into 10 square. And 10 raised to 3 becoming 36 into 10 raised to 5. यानी कि 3.6 into 10 raised to 6 joule. तो 1 kWh equal to 3.6 into 10 raised to 6 joule. Then we come to the next topic is work energy theorem. This is most important topic. What is work energy theorem? State and explain. Derive the expression. And that work energy theorem is given by the mathematically W equal to delta K. So we derive this equation. Kaise dekhi yahan par? So actually you know very well, when you consider a one body is placed on a horizontal surface, you apply the force. So what will happen here? It displaces. As it displaces, it experiences a certain displacement. So the product of force and displacement gives the work done on the body. On the other side, due to the body came into motion, or मान लो पहले से ही बॉडी मोशन में है, कुछ वेलोसिटी के साथ जा रही है. एज फॉर एग्जाम्पल, योर फ्रेंड इज गोइंग ऑन ए बाइसिकल विद सर्टेन स्पीड, एंड फ्रॉम द बैक साइड यू आर अप्लाइंग द फोर्स. सो व्हाट विल हैपन हियर? इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ मोशन, इफ यू आर अप्लाइंग द फोर्स, देन द स्पीड ऑफ इट्स मोशन विल इंक्रीज. पहले 5 मीटर पर सेकेंड की स्पीड से साइकिल चला रहा था, फोर्स पीछे से आपको इसके मोशन में लगा दिया, तो स्पीड 10 मीटर पर सेकेंड हो गई, यानी कि इट्स वेलोसिटी इंक्रीज हुई. वेलोसिटी इंक्रीज हुई, दैट मीन्स काइनेटिक एनर्जी चेंज हुई, काइनेटिक एनर्जी इंक्रीज हुई. तो यहां पे फोर्स अप्लाई करने से ऑन द बॉडी के ऊपर दो चीज मिलती है, एक वर्क मिलता है, फोर्स इनटू डिस्प्लेसमेंट, ऑन द अनदर साइड चेंज इन काइनेटिक एनर्जी मिलता है. तो दिस फैक्ट शोस देयर इज अ सर्टेन रिलेशन बिटवीन वर्क एंड चेंज इन काइनेटिक एनर्जी. दिस थिंग हैव बीन रिटन हियर. व्हेन अ बॉडी ऑफ मास m इज एक्टेड अपॉन बाय फोर्स, तो जैसे ही फोर्स लगाया तो इसमें एक्सेलरेशन प्रोड्यूस होगा. एक्सेलरेशन इज प्रोड्यूस्ड इन इट. एक्सेलरेशन मतलब क्या? चेंज इन वेलोसिटी. सो द वेलोसिटी ऑफ अ बॉडी चेंजेस, एंड वेलोसिटी ऑफ अ बॉडी चेंजेस की वजह से अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस इक्वेशन काइनेटिक एनर्जी ऑफ द बॉडी आल्सो चेंजेस. ऑन द अदर साइड, ड्यू टू द फोर्स एक्टिंग ऑन अ बॉडी, इट डिस्प्लेसेस. कुछ डिस्प्लेसमेंट हुआ तो फोर्स इनटू डिस्प्लेसमेंट आपको क्या मिलेगा? हेंस वर्क इज सेड टू बी डन ऑन द बॉडी. तो दिस टू फैक्ट्स इंडिकेट्स दैट there should be some relation between the work done on a body and change in kinetic energy. And we want to establish this relation between the work done and change in kinetic energy. And that's why we start from this point. So when a force is applied due to which if displacement is occurring on by the body, then work done by the force equal to F dot D. The work done by the force F on a body is W equal to vector F dot D, where D is what? Displacement. But we know, according to Newton's second law of motion, this force equal to what? Mass into acceleration. So substituting here, W equal to ma, m vector a dot d, it is equation 1. But for the rectilinear motion of a body, as we have studied earlier, the equations of motion of a body moving with constant acceleration, there were 3 equations. Out of which I consider the third equation, v square minus v zero square equal to 2 vector ad. So for rectilinear motion of a body under the constant acceleration, v square minus v zero square equal to twice vector ad, where v is final velocity, v zero is initial velocity. So where v zero and v are initial and final velocities. So substituting this, then to this equation now, you multiplying by m by 2 on both the sides, यहाँ पर भी m by 2, यहाँ पर भी m by 2, तो ये क्या हो जाएगा? 1 of mv square, और ये क्या हो जाएगा? 1 of mv zero square, m by 2 से 2 to cancel, mad मिलेगा, तो multiplying by m by 2 on both the sides, to this equation we get 1 of mv square minus 1 of mv zero square equal to m vector a dot vector d. This is equation 2. For equation 1, m a dot d on the right side. For equation 2, m vector a dot d is also on the right side. It means what? Comparing these two equations, we can say as the right hand side are equal, their left hand side should also be equal. That means we can write W is equal to 1 of mv square minus 1 of mv0 square. So from equations 1 and 2, W equal to 1 of mv square minus 1 of mv0 square. 1 of mv square is kf, that means final kinetic energy, because v was the final velocity. And 1 of mv0 square is ki, is the initial kinetic energy. So this is denoted by the symbol kf, this is denoted by the symbol ki, so kf minus ki. The difference is that it means what? This is the change in kinetic energy. Thus W equal to delta K is equal to kf minus ki is the symbol of change in kinetic energy. So you can write from this statement, what was W? W was the work done by the net force or by the resultant force. The work done by the resultant force on a body is equal to the change in kinetic energy of a body. So this statement is known as work energy theorem. And then we have to see the next theory topic. It is work done by variable force. So now we have to understand the work done by variable force. What is the meaning of variable force? Earlier I have said already, the force whose magnitude and direction, sometimes magnitude only goes on changing, direction remains constant. Sometimes direction goes on changing, magnitude remains constant. And sometimes magnitude and direction both goes on changing at every instant, at every moment on the path of the motion of a particle. Then such a force is known as variable force. And most probably we have to deal with variable force in physics. The constant force is rare. So here variable force, we have to derive the equation of work done by variable force. We have got the equation of work done by constant force, and it was simply scalar product of vector F and vector D. That means, yahan pe kya milega aapko? W is equal to integration milega. Integration of vector F dot DL. This is the difference. So, yahan pe aapko milega integration from initial point A to final point B for the path of the motion. And it can be read as the line integration of force over the curved path from A to B. So this is the equation of work done by variable force. How we will get it? Let us see. So here I am considering this is the xy plane. In this xy plane, let a particle moves along this curved path in xy plane under the effect of variable force. So at all these different points of the path of motion, there are the different forces are acting. Different forces are acting, matlab iska magnitude and direction both goes on changing. At one moment the force is F1 along this direction. At another moment the force is F2 along this direction of magnitude, another one. At third moment the force is third F3, force is F4, F5, like this one. So you can see that. Let's consider a motion of a particle in XY plane along this curved path under the effect of variable force. So consider a particle is moving along the curved path AB in XY plane under the effect of variable force. The magnitude and direction of force at different points on the path will be different because the force is variable. Now we want to calculate the total work done by this variable force. So, kaise calculate karne ka? In order to calculate the total work done by this variable force, this entire path from A to B should be divided into very large number of small segments, chote chote small segments is tarah se, barabar A se leke yahan tak ka, dusra yahan tak ka, tisra yahan tak ka, chautha yahan tak ka, panchwa yahan tak ka, chote chote displacements, and this displacement should be considered as possible as straight one, jitna ho sake itna small displacement. To aapko ye displacement ke number kaise milenge? Bahut hi zyada. Because they are very small segments. In order to calculate the total work done, the whole path is assumed to be divided into very large number of very small segments. And these small segments like vector delta L1, vector delta L2, vector delta Ln. Why vector delta L ka symbol used here? Because this curved path neither completely in x direction nor completely in y direction, as it is in xy plane, I denote this small segment is delta L1. Agar ye straight line x direction mein hai, to delta x1, delta x2, delta x3. Y direction mein straight line, to delta y1, delta y2, delta y3. Lekin curved path hai in xy plane, isiliye ye sare sare chote segments ko अब क्या कहेंगे? डेल्टा एल वन, डेल्टा एल टू, डेल्टा एल थ्री, डेल्टा एल फोर, डेल्टा एल फाइव अप टू डेल्टा एल एन. तो डेल्टा एल वन, डेल्टा एल टू, डेल्टा एल थ्री, डेल्टा एल एन. तो एक्चुअली दीज आर द स्मॉल डिस्प्लेसमेंट एक्सपीरियंस्ड बाय दैट बॉडी अंडर द इफेक्ट ऑफ डिफरेंट फोर्सेस. विच फोर्सेस आर देयर? लेट एफ वन, एफ टू, एफ एन बी द फोर्सेस एट रिस्पेक्टिव सेगमेंट. यानी एफ वन विद फोर्स एक्टिंग ऑन द ऑब्जेक्ट एट डिस्प्लेसमेंट डेल्टा एफ वन, एफ टू विद फोर्स ड्यूरिंग द डिस्प्लेसमेंट डेल्टा एल टू, एफ थ्री विद फोर्स ड्यूरिंग द डिस्प्लेसमेंट डेल्टा एल थ्री, एफ एन विद फोर्स ड्यूरिंग द डिस्प्लेसमेंट डेल्टा एल एन. So let F1, F2, F3, Fn be the forces at respective segments. And these segments are considered as possible as small, and they are the straight one. And during this small displacement, which will be the forces there? We have to consider that force is remaining constant in magnitude as well as in direction. So, jab tak ye chota displacement experience hota hai by the body, tab tak ke liye उसका वो रिस्पेक्टिव फोर्स का मैग्नीट्यूड एंड डायरेक्शन वी आर कंसीडरिंग एज कांस्टेंट एंड ड्यू टू दिस फैक्ट द फोर्स ओवर ईच सेगमेंट कैन बी कंसीडर्ड एज कांस्टेंट देयरफॉर द टोटल वर्क डन कैन बी कैलकुलेटेड फॉर ईच सेगमेंट बाय टेकिंग द स्केलर प्रोडक्ट ऑफ दैट लोकल फोर्स लाइक एफ वन एफ टू एफ थ्री एफ फोर F1 local force to displacement delta L1, F2 local force to displacement delta L2, F3 local force to displacement delta L3. So by taking the scalar product of local force and small displacement, जो आगे हमने दिखा था work done by constant force की formula, scalar product of force and displacement, यानी कि F1 force लगता है तो displacement delta L1 है, तो F1 dot delta L1 is the work done delta W1, F2 dot delta L2 is the work done delta W2, F3 dot delta L3 is the work done W3, like that one. तो इस तरह सबको क्या मिलेगा? बहुत सारे works मिलेंगे. And taking the sum of all this work, because work is scalar quantity, तो इसका तो simply sum होगा. You will get the total work done starting from initial point up to the ending point B. Then the total work can be obtained by taking the sum of all such scalar products, that is W equal to, you can write W1 plus W2 plus W3 plus W4 plus Wn. What is W1? W1 is represented by vector F1 dot delta L1, W2 is represented by vector F2 dot delta L2, W3 is represented by vector F3 dot delta L3, and in the same way, last one, Wn is represented by vector Fn dot delta Ln. And ये सब का sum that can be written as mathematically by using the symbol of sigma. So that total work done W is equal to sigma from A to B. यानि A से B तक का ये पूरा path जितने small segments में divide किया हुआ है, सारे segments के लिए scalar product of local force and displacement और वो सब का sum. तो क्या कहेंगे? That W is equal to sigma from A to B of vector Fi dot डेल्टा एल आई, वेर आई इज इक्वल टू वन टू एन. अगर ये पूरा पाथ 100 पार्ट्स में डिवाइड किया जाता है तो 1 से लेकर 100 तक, अगर ये कवर्ड पाथ ए टू बी 50 पार्ट्स में डिवाइड करते हैं तो 1 से लेकर 50 तक का, अगर ये पूरा कवर्ड पाथ फ्रॉम 1 से लेकर 25 तक के डिवाइड स्मॉल सेगमेंट में डिवाइड करते हैं तो 1 से लेकर 25, अगर ये पूरा पाथ ए टू बी 1 सेगमेंट से लेके 1000 सेगमेंट तक में डिवाइड करते तो 1 से लेके 1000 तक. तो दस इन शॉर्ट W इज इक्वल सिग्मा ऑफ Fi डॉट डेल्टा Li फ्रॉम E टू B, वेयर द समेशन इज फ्रॉम कहां से कहां तक, A से B तक, मतलब फ्रॉम इनिशियल पोजीशन A टू फाइनल पोजीशन B तक. बट नाउ यू हैव टू अप्लाई द मैथमेटिक्स बिकॉज़ द नंबर ऑफ पार्ट्स फ्रॉम A टू B, sorry, the number of segments from A to B are how many? That we don't know. That depends. ये curved path कितना curved है? इसके पर. तो now here, यानी कि you have to consider this segment delta L as possible as very small. तो इसको क्या कहेंगे? Mathematically, let it tends to zero. It approaches to zero. तो अब देखिए यहाँ पे, if the displacements are allowed to approaches to zero. यानी कि ये स्मॉल डिस्प्लेसमेंट, ये स्मॉल सेगमेंट जितना हो सके इतना कम, लेकिन एग्जैक्टली जीरो नहीं. इसीलिए कैसा, इफ द स्मॉल डिस्प्लेसमेंट्स आर अलाउड टू अप्रोचेस टू जीरो देन द नंबर ऑफ टर्म्स इन द सम इंक्रीजेस. तो ये सम में बहुत सारे, जितने आप छोटे छोटे सेगमेंट्स लेते जाएंगे इतने नंबर ऑफ टर्म्स ए से तक बी तक के कितने बढ़ते जाएंगे, सेगमेंट्स अगर ज्यादा लेंथ के लेते जाएंगे तो नंबर ऑफ टर्म्स कम मिलेंगे, स्मॉल सेगमेंट्स और भी स्मॉल लेते जाएंगे तो नंबर ऑफ टर्म्स बढ़ते जाएंगे. तो इफ द डिस्प्लेसमेंट्स आर अलाउड टू अप्रोचेस टू जीरो देन द नंबर ऑफ टर्म्स इन द सम इंक्रीजेस विदाउट लिमिट, इसकी कोई लिमिट नहीं होगी. बट ऐसा करने से ये पूरा सम की एक आपको डिफाइनेट वैल्यू मिलेगी. बट द सम अप्रोचेस टू ए डिफाइनेट वैल्यू एंड इन द लैंग्वेज ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स इसको कहते हैं इंटीग्रेशन. That's why you can write this W is equal to, अब इसको किस तरह से लिखेंगे, limit of modulus of delta Li tends to 0 of sigma from a to b of fi dot delta Li. तो ये जो पूरा टर्म है sigma, ये जो पूरा टर्म है that is replaced by integration. This limit delta modulus of delta Li tends to 0 of sigma from a to b is replaced by integration and at that time fi की जगह fi का सिंबल fi रहेगा लेकिन delta L के बदले में और भी small होगा इसीलिए dl हो जाएगा. तो this summation gets converted into integration, and gives us the total work W equal to integration from a to b. This can be read as इस तरह का सिंबल रीड एज इंटीग्रेशन. कहां से कहां तक का, लोअर लिमिट ए अपर लिमिट बी. तो ए टू बी किसका, ऑफ वेक्टर एफ डॉट, अब डेल्टा एल के बदले में डीएल हो जाएगा वेक्टर एफ डॉट डीएल एंड डॉट प्रोडक्ट निकाल दो क्या मिलेगा, इंटीग्रेशन फ्रॉम ए टू बी एफ डीएल कॉस थीटा, एफ डीएल कॉस थीटा. तो दिस इज द फॉर्मूला ऑफ वर्क डन बाय वेरिएबल फोर्स, इंटीग्रेशन फ्रॉम ए टू बी ऑफ एफ डॉट डीएल for integration from a to b f dl cos theta and that can be read as the line integration, kyunki ye puri curved path ke upar ka integration hai a se leke b tak ka, isliye isko kya kahenge line integration. kabhi kabhi koi surface ke upar ka integration hota hai to surface integration aata hai, wo aap padhenge 12th standard mein. to is the line integration of the force, line integration from a to b kiska, of the force over the curved path from a to b. okay.